Welcome to the Wells Fargo Monthly Economic Outlook. I'm Charlie Dougherty, and with me is Tim Quinlan. Tim, so let's start off with a notable change that we made to our forecast. So for the past few months, we've been saying that the Federal Reserve was getting ready to cut interest rates soon, and that they were going to move at a gradual and cautious pace. But now we're saying that the Fed is going to be a little bit more aggressive and decisive in lowering rates. So why don't you take us through that change in thinking?
Sure, yes, kind of a big move in a relatively short period of time. So what kind of happened there is we've been experiencing kind of a trend decline in a number of different labor market indicators, whether you're looking at a slowing in job openings or a drop off in the share of consumers that say that the jobs market is plentiful in terms of jobs. But nobody really had much appetite for those kind of measures when the monthly jobs report just kept coming in stronger than expected month after month after month. And then basically the July jobs report saw a major pivot there, and we finally saw the weakness evident in all these other indicators show up in the big monthly jobs report. And that kind of woke up financial markets to this dynamic that the fixation that we'd had throughout the course of the last 12 months on inflation kind of put a little bit too much emphasis on half of the Fed's mandate. And the deterioration in the labor market kind of renews focus on the full employment side of the Fed's mandate. And in that regard, they may have some catching up to do to dial back the restrictive policy environment that's been in place for more than a year now. And we weren't alone in this kind of development. You've seen kind of a big move across the board in financial markets, particularly in rates. Charlie, in your world, we've got mortgage rates below 7% now. You know, how is that hitting you, and what do you think about the impact that has for housing?
Yeah, so lower mortgage rates should help the housing market, which is still mired in affordability challenges. So if you kind of zoom out, the pace of home sales is still really slow. The mortgage rates have come down below 7%, as you mentioned, and as the Fed eases monetary policy, we should see a little bit lower mortgage rates moving forward. And so that should help affordability, that should lift home sales, boost single family construction, and overall be a benefit to the residential sector. Now, you're already starting to see a pickup in refinancing activity. You're starting to see an increase in home equity lines of credit. And I think that has some implications for the household sector. So Tim, what about the U.S. consumer? How have you updated your thinking on the consumer, given all these changes we've been talking about?
Yeah, it's kind of a hard thing to reconcile, but the latest data on the labor market indicates kind of a significant slowing. Those numbers are generally coming in weaker than expected. But when you look at the consumer, those numbers have actually come in much better than expected. Second quarter GDP growth was much larger than expected, largely due to the contribution from consumer spending. And you know, as we record this, we're looking forward to retail sales data later this week. That'll give us July. You know, signs point to a pretty decent July retail sales report. So if realized, that kind of puts us on track for a pretty solid Q3 in consumer spending as well. Yet we have to be, you know, chastened a little bit in our expectations when we think about this in the context of the softening in the jobs market. You've already seen the excess savings be depleted from the pandemic era. You've seen a big run-up in credit last year, but more recently that credit growth is, you know, I'm talking revolving credit, has kind of moderated to an extent. Two out of the past 3 months, we've seen outright declines in revolving credit. You know, you mentioned the home equity lines. That is increasingly looking like the last line of defense to sustain a consumer in an environment when things are kind of deteriorating a little bit. In fact, you know, recession risks have begun to rise. You know, how do you think about that in the broader context of our outlook?
I would say that the risk of a recession is elevated and has come up a little bit due to the weakening that we're seeing in the labor market, but we still believe that this expansion is going to remain intact, even if we do lose a little bit of momentum. As soon as the Fed begins to cut interest rates, that should help some of the sectors of the economy that have been hard hit by higher rates, such as the housing market, which we talked about, also commercial real estate, the manufacturing sector, and then consumer spending and business investment should eventually benefit as well. So as the Fed dials back restriction, that should help the economy return to a more trend-like pace of growth. So we've been experiencing some turbulence recently, but as the Fed dials back restriction, that should help us move to a smoother altitude. So with that, Tim, thank you for joining us, and thank you all for tuning in. Please join us again next month for our latest monthly economic outlook.